This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree. In this edition of ID That Tree, we're going to go over some of the leaf characteristics you may encounter when you're attempting to identify some of our broadleaf deciduous trees here in Indiana. And we'll start with the simplest, and that is the simple leaf. And so, as the name implies, it is one leaf blade attached to a stem, and the stem attaches to the twig of the tree, and there will be a bud at the base of that leaf stem, defining where the leaf starts. So a leaf stem and one leaf blade, this is eastern redbud. We can contrast that with compound leaves. And compound leaves are made up of several leaflets attached to a leaf stem that then attaches to the twig. And so we'll find a bud at the base of the leaf stem, but no buds where the leaflets attach to the stem of the leaf. And so that helps us define this as not a single leaf, but a leaflet that is part of the broader leaf itself. And so this is blue ash, a compound leaf, and called pinnately compound, in that it has a long leaf stem with leaflets on the side and oftentimes at the terminal end. We have another type of compound leaf, and that is called palmately compound, where the leaflets are attached to a single point on the leaf stem, forming something looking like the fingers on a palm. And so this is Ohio buckeye, palmately compound leaf. And then we have what's called doubly compound leaves. And so this is honey locust, and honey locust can have both doubly compound and singly compound leaves. This is doubly compound because we have a leaf attachment to the stem here where the bud would be, a leaf stem, and then side leaf stems that contain the leaflets. And so this whole structure is one single leaf, doubly compound in composition. So leaf stems, and then leaflets on the secondary stems in most cases. This is a pretty small leaf as doubly compound leaves go. We have a Kentucky coffee tree and also devil's walking stick that are other doubly compound leaves, and these leaves can be 2 to 3 feet long or even larger. So hopefully that discussion of leaf types can help you when it comes time to identify some of our deciduous hardwood trees here in Indiana.